Hi guys, welcome back. So in the theme of it being a wedding inspired week, since Sean's wedding was last weekend, I did the bridal makeup tutorial earlier this week, and now I'm gonna show you guys some wedding hairstyles. I'm gonna call these bridesmaid wedding hairstyles. Also, if you're attending a wedding, if you wanna get real fancy with it, you can always do this hairstyle as an attendee to a wedding. So let's get started. Okay. So it's not so secret that I love a good weave. And if you're gonna be in a wedding, even if you don't love a good weave, you need to figure out how to fall in love with a good weave, because I think a lot of hair is great, especially if you're wearing your hair down. So I actually wore two weaves. I'm gonna show you, oh my gosh, for the first time in Sean's wedding this past weekend. So I have my two Halo Couture weaves. Both of them are like kind of pre-curled because they're still curled from last weekend. I'm gonna put the shorter one, that's the 16-inch one, over the 20-inch one. These are both colors F112. I'm gonna set it onto my head like so. And then I'm gonna pull my real hair through. The more real hair you pull through, the better, especially if you're wearing two weaves, because it can get kind of heavy. So to get this look, you can either wear two weaves, or you can do what Sean's hairdresser from Dancing with the Stars did on her hair this past weekend. His name's Dean Banowitz, and I am obsessed with him. He is so awesome and so funny, and oh my gosh, you guys would just die. So anyway, I watched him do her hair, and he just got the extensions from Sally's, but he used the long pieces in the box of extensions, not those little tiny ones. And what he did, he curled a section of her hair about this big. He started at the bottom, teased it at the base, put that extension on, that long extension, curled that extension, then took the next section of hair about this long, curled it, teased it at the base, put the next extension on, and he layered it all the way at the back of her head. So she had a base of hair like this too without wearing the two sets of halos.
Sean, how are you feeling?
I'm feeling flat up.
This hair is looking flat, but when you fly in, somebody from the LA, from the Dancing with the Stars set.
From the LA.
You are not going to get anything less than spectacular. So can she dance tonight like she danced on Dancing with the Stars, and it will not fly out? He's going to lock that weave in.
Yeah, I'm on MacGyver there. You give me a pack of sugar, it'll never move.
And if you want to do back.
Okay, so I've already curled my halo, or it's curled from this past weekend, but I'm going to show you guys the tools that we use to curl it. And she curled my hair with a barrel of a curling iron about like this. This is, I'd say, an inch and a half. But I want to show you this too, because Dean gave me this. I'm going to do a full tutorial on this, but this is what he curled Sean's with. And he went in. This isn't plugged in right now. You push this, and then this goes, and this barrel twists. But see these little teeth right here? They smooth the hair so into the curl. So if you're a person that has to kind of straighten your hair out and then curl it, this is gonna be an awesome tool for you. It's called the InStyler.
He's created this hair product that I'm gonna show you guys, and it's so awesome. It like smooths and curls at the same time. I can't even describe it, so Dean, you're gonna have to. It's really epic.
I'm gonna have you come around so I can show you. So when you close it, it activates the rotation.
Okay.
And then if you want it to go the opposite direction, you double click it. It's called the InStyler Max.
InStyler Max.
So you just take the hair, wrap the hair around the barrel.
Like, I just didn't know where it was because I was like, where did you put it?
See how it's going the wrong way?
Yeah.
I'm going to double click, and now it's going the right direction. So I just hold it, let the polishing girl do its job.
And his hair product.
And when you open it up, you just get a perfect texture.
Oh my gosh,
layer.
Beautiful.
Might as well toss it
now
in.
If you want to smooth the hair, you just take a section of hair. I always tell people, make sure you comb it so there's no tangles. And then you just glide it down. Slows the new fast. The first set of brushes aligns the hair so it passes evenly over the polishing barrel. So you can see how beautiful, smooth, silky, and shiny. Now, more tension, more body. So I'm putting a lot of tension on those ends because I want to get a bevel so it looks like it's a proper blowout.
Oh my gosh. Crazy.
But you can see how shiny it is too.
I know.
And I'm gonna link it. Okay, so this is a hairstyle inspired by the hairstyle that Libby Barnes did on me. So teasing is bae for a bridesmaid. So I'm gonna go in. I'm parting my hair in the middle because it just works better. Anytime you're teasing your hair, don't hold it straight up, especially don't hold it this way. Hold it to where it's going the opposite direction. And just tease, tease, tease. Take it in sections. And just tease the heck out of it. And you're done. Just kidding. Okay, so I've got everything teased. I'm gonna smooth it to where I don't look like a crazy person that stuck a finger in a light socket on somebody else's wedding day. And you can obviously like go way crazier with the teasing, but for the sake of time, that's amazing. Just getting my hair done. I did my makeup myself, but let me introduce Libby to you back here. Libby is killing it on the hair. I have double halo in right now, and I'm trying to get Libby to start a YouTube channel. Libby's like all up in the country scene. Her boyfriend is Hunter Hayes, in case you guys have ever heard of him. Probably haven't. Okay, so Libby left the front part of my hair out, but I'm actually going to keep it. I'm going to keep it in this look just to show you guys. Okay, so you're going to take two pieces of hair. It would be great if you had two long pieces of hair. And don't worry, like if you have an extension showing, you can cover that up at the end. So, take two pieces of hair, and you're just going to twist. All the way around. Okay. Now, here's what I'm going to do to this. This is like fascinating to me. I'm going to go ahead and pin this just so it doesn't fall. This isn't going to be the actual pin that I use. So now you're going to take that twist and you're going to pull every other little twist that you've got there. You're just going to kind of pull it out. It's so hard to do without looking. See that? And you just keep pulling that out, pulling it out. And it's really, it's super hard for me to do like without looking at it right now, but you kind of get the gist of that. And if you're a person that would love to do like a halfway braided look, but can't do a braid like to save your life, this is a great option for you. Then you're gonna do the other side. I'll speed this side up, but you know what I'm doing. Okay, another hairstyle that you can do is that kind of old Hollywood glam. You're gonna have your hair down, my hair is still curled. I'm gonna part my hair, a deep part, wherever your part is. I'm gonna tease this side just a little bit underneath. And I'll deal with that in a minute. I'm now gonna take this side of my hair and I'm gonna take a pretty big chunk, this chunk in the front. You can also use a hair wand for this. And I'm just straightening that end of the real hair into the extension. I'm gonna start at the top because that's where I want it like the most, kind of that wave. And then I'll let go about an inch of hair every few seconds. And you want to take it out. You want to take the end and kind of pull that in. Don't ask me why that works, but it does. Okay, then you want to continue to shape it with that hairspray. Spray that spray on there. And then shape it and you continue on. And then the rest of the hair is similar to just that curl that I had in there. I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna do the same thing with this piece of hair. Pull it out, take the end, tug that end like that. And then you blend those curls together. That kind of vintage curl is all about that like blend of the curl. You know, this is a really short video, so for the sake of time, you see how I did the curl all the way to the bottom. And then always make sure the very bottom of that hair is kind of curled in like that. And then on this side, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put this side behind my ear. I'm gonna spray it. I'm gonna really, really slick that side down. And then I'm gonna pin this part behind my ear. Just to kind of get that old Hollywood glamour kind of look. It's really hard to show you guys these hairstyles while I'm sitting here and you can't see my whole head, but you see how easy that was to achieve? And I just showed you like the steps to do it. Of course, you can do the back of your hair. You do those same curls, curl it, let it go, let it go, let it go. Pull that end out and then shape it with your comb and your hairspray.
So,
with
the styler, the tool. So it's a horizontal section. Do you see that?
Mm-hmm.
So I pinch the hair.
Okay.
I'm gonna wrap the hair around the barrel. Okay. And I don't ever let that twist go.
Okay.
When you close it, let the polishing barrel do its J-O-B. Now, when you're ready, I'm going to just let it sit just a little bit longer. You're anticipating it.
Uh-huh.
So you take this and you unwrap the hair. It's just a regular curl, right?
Uh-huh.
But when you take this and you tug it, you now have a vintage look.
You're welcome.
You're my gosh.
And that's that vintage wave. You also like, if you guys are doing your bridesmaid's hair really early in the day, you can take those long silver little pins and you can take a piece of tissue paper or anything like that and you can pin where the curl dips in.
If you're doing Dancing with the Stars or anything like that, then we would take and clip this and spray so those ridges are really strong.
Wow. Okay, yeah, that's awesome. That's not even fair.
But I have, if you Google vintage wave, you'll see it.
Your video?
Yeah.
What's your YouTube channel called?
Just my name. Dean Manowetz, B-A-N-O-W-E-T-Z, Echo Tango Zulu. Okay, great.
Thanks, guys.
That really helps like the longevity of it in this day and so. Just a quick little Hollywood vintage look. Okay, and last but not least, we're gonna do that kind of slick back, messy bun look. You can do this on a half back look, you can do this like everything back. I'm going to tease the heck out of this top part of my hair. First. You're even gonna tease this part of your hair too. I don't wanna like mess my weave up too much, but. And this is a little trick. So you take your curling iron or you take a straightener and you take some sections of your hair and kind of kink them together like so after you've teased it. This is what's gonna make them kind of like stick together and get that kind of piecey look. I always wondered how to do that, and then Dean taught me how to do it. He did this to Sean's this weekend too. Straighten them together. Okay. People think these hairstyles are so complicated. They're so not. Okay. So what you wanna do, you wanna always work with like an open hand like this, you know? You're tousling your hair back. You want it to be piecey, you want it to be tously. So I'm just gonna start pinning randomly. You want to go to on the back. You want to twist things down and pin underneath, always on all of these things. See, even those pieces that are like going cray like that are A-okay. Actually, they're good. So pull those pieces back. You can even twist them a little bit to make them look even more like piecey, sexy. Take the end of a rat tail comb and pull all these pieces. You're gonna spray and spray and spray like as you keep going along, like you keep spraying. You know that this is how you pull a tease out too, by the way. You don't like pull it out by with your hands, like pull it out kinda like so. I'm doing quick versions of all these hairstyles, so obviously like the more time you spend. Then you're gonna take the pieces on the outside. So I'm gonna start like with, you know, an area of hair about like this big. I'm gonna pull this together. And I'm gonna do the same thing that I did. I'm gonna twist it. And I'm gonna pin it. And I'm gonna take those outside pieces again, bring them up to the top, twist it, and pin it. This hairstyle is all about just getting all that hair pinned up back there. This is not a perfect hairstyle. This is a like a loose, sexy back. Twist it and pin it. And you get the drift. You can put the end of that hair up. You can leave it down. And this is a really beautiful look. With like, this is not a perfect version, but you get the drift. You can put baby's breath or even like some sort of piece of hair jewelry down that, and it's just beautiful. So I hope you guys enjoyed these three really quick, easy hairstyles inspired by this last weekend when I was a bridesmaid. If you did, give this video a thumbs up. Please subscribe if you haven't, and come back for much more coming soon.
This on this side, you can start horizontally.
Yeah, I did. Yeah, come on.
Oh, yeah, me too. And
yes, and fix your lash. Yeah.
And then you can turn vertical.
Yes.
If you want the swoop.
Great.
So I'll do a bigger section so you can see it.
Oh my gosh, I always need that.
So, horizontal. Smooth, smooth, smooth. Just like you would a round brush and a blow dryer, I'm gonna take it back. And you have this really great swoop.
Oh yeah, you sold me. I see how you sell that.